China has recently opened this highly anticipated bridge, estimated at $6.7 billion. But it's not just a bridge. It extends further to become an underwater structure, and additionally, on both sides, you will also find man-made islands. And it also holds 10 world records as well. Undoubtedly, it's one of the most complex cross-sea cluster projects in the world. But what exactly is this new bridge? And how is it different from other bridges globally? The Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge is a massive cross-sea passage in southern China, spanning 24 kilometers. It features not only a bridge, but also two underwater tunnels and man-made islands. This infrastructure project significantly shortens travel time between Zhongshan, a city known for its cultural heritage, and Shenzhen, a prominent technology hub. Located on opposite sides of the Pearl River estuary in Guangdong province, the bridge reduces travel duration from a lengthy 2 hours to just around 30 minutes, enhancing regional connectivity and economic integration. Now, on June 30th, this new impressive bridge has been opened, and it's a crucial transportation project in the Greater Bay Area of Guangdong, where approximately 86 million people live, including cities like Hong Kong, Macau, Zhongshan, and Shenzhen in Guangdong Province, China. This area is characterized by its extensive coastline and waterways. So this bridge is like a transportation backbone because it plays a vital role in connecting urban centers on both sides of the Pearl River estuary smoothly. It will reshape the road network layout of the Pearl River estuary, profoundly impacting the economic and social development of the GBA. Building this bridge was no small feat. The construction began in 2017 and faced obstacles such as frequent typhoons, high salinity, humidity, and severe siltation, which affected over 10,000 workers during the 7-year building period. One of the most daunting tasks was building the underwater tunnel. Constructing such a tunnel underwater presented unique engineering challenges, including ensuring stability, managing water pressure, and maintaining structural integrity. In November 2023, the undersea tunnel was completed. Now you might be wondering, what are the key features of this bridge? One standout feature of the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge is its impressive achievement of setting 10 world records. The Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge, for instance, holds several remarkable titles. It has the world's largest span for a fully offshore steel box girder suspension bridge at 1,666 meters, and it boasts the world's highest bridge deck, towering 91 meters above the sea. This bridge also offers the highest clearance for ships passing underneath. Additionally, it includes the world's largest anchor for an offshore suspension bridge made of about 344,000 cubic meters of concrete. It underwent a rigorous load test where 136 trucks, each carrying 35 tons of weight, were positioned on both sides of the bridge. It's also tested to withstand the strongest winds among suspension bridges, facing speeds up to 83.7 meters per second. The bridge deck itself is the largest of its kind globally, covering a vast area of 378,800 square meters with hot mix epoxy asphalt. The undersea tunnel part of the project is equally impressive. Spanning 6.8 kilometers, it's the world's longest two-way, eight-lane tube tunnel going in each direction. The tunnel is also the widest underwater steel shell concrete tube, with sections reaching up to 55.6 meters wide and 10.6 meters tall. It includes a central pipe gallery that houses essential facilities like power and water supply, drainage, firefighting, communication, and intelligent control systems. This gallery also serves as an emergency exit route. Moreover, the tunnel features state-of-the-art LED lighting, which includes smart, adjustable, full-color landscape lights installed on both sides. These lights can dynamically change colors in response to temperature variations and traffic conditions. They are green when everything is normal, but turn red during emergencies. The lights can also change gradually from yellow to green along the tunnel, helping guide people during evacuations. At the core of the tunnel's lighting system is a smart visual monitoring system installed in the central control center. This system monitors the tunnel lighting in real time, providing several management benefits. The tunnel also incorporates a range of advanced devices to ensure its safe and reliable operation. These include 14 robots, dual wavelength flame detectors, and Beidou satellite navigation signal simulators. The robots perform regular patrols along designated routes within the emergency exits and cable channels. Their role is to monitor equipment and environmental conditions in the pipe gallery, enhancing operational oversight and prompt response capabilities. And if there's an accident, these robots quickly capture real-time footage and send it to authorities for immediate assessment and action. Moreover, the tunnel features the world's largest single-volume cast for a steel shell tube, totaling an impressive 910,000 cubic meters of self-compacting concrete. It introduces innovative designs, such as the world's first underwater expressway and airport interchange, making transportation connections seamless. The tunnel's final joint uses the world's widest repeatedly foldable M-shaped water stop, ensuring strong structure and safety. In addition to these features, the project includes two artificial islands. The western island is uniquely diamond-shaped, resembling a kite on the sea, while the eastern island spans an area equivalent to 48 standard football fields. These islands not only enhance the aesthetic appeal of the project, but also serve functional roles in supporting infrastructure and promoting environmental sustainability in the region. However, the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge isn't the first bridge here in China. There's already the 55-kilometer-long Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge. And now, many of you may be wondering, how is the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge different from the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge? The Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge and the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge are both significant infrastructure projects in China's Greater Bay Area, but they serve distinct purposes and have notable differences. The Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge primarily connects the cities of Hong Kong, Zhuhai, and Macau, fostering closer ties between these major urban centers. In contrast, the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge bridges Shenzhen and Zhongshan, enhancing economic integration within the Pearl River Delta region. In terms of size, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge spans 55 kilometers, making it longer than the 24 kilometers of the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge. Moreover, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge was a more costly project, totaling around $18.8 billion, which is over 2.5 times the cost of the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge, which amounted to approximately $6.1 billion. Design-wise, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge comprises a series of bridges, tunnels, and artificial islands, whereas the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge features two bridges, two artificial islands, and an underwater tunnel. The Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge has also achieved several world records in suspension bridge engineering, tunnel construction, and underwater highway interchanges. From a practical standpoint, the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge significantly reduces travel time between the two cities, cutting it from 2 hours to approximately 30 minutes. Conversely, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge journey from Hong Kong to Macau takes about 40 minutes. Now comes the question of how the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge will impact Hong Kong's logistics sector. The opening of the Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge is expected to have significant implications for Hong Kong's logistics sector, according to various experts. Some believe that the bridge will enhance the competitiveness of Shenzhen's logistics sector by connecting directly to Shenzhen's airport, reducing travel time, and cutting costs. This could lead trucks to prefer using this new route over Hong Kong, posing direct competition. Others point out challenges with alternative routes, such as higher tolls, longer distances, and immigration procedures, which could be avoided by sending goods directly to Shenzhen instead. However, some see the new bridge as beneficial, allowing goods from Hong Kong to reach cities on the western side of the Pearl River more efficiently. This perspective suggests potential growth for Hong Kong's logistics industry and increased travel between Shenzhen and Hong Kong. However, both the new Shenzhen-Zhongshan Bridge and the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge are integral parts of the Greater Bay Area, forming a network of bridges and tunnels across rivers and sea channels in the region. These infrastructure projects are designed to enhance connectivity between cities within the Bay Area, facilitating easier travel for people and goods. This improved connectivity aims to stimulate economic growth, streamline transportation, and foster closer collaboration among cities in the region. So, what are your thoughts on this new infrastructure? Do you think it will enhance regional cooperation and economic growth? Share your opinions in the comments below. If you found this information valuable, don't forget to like and share to spread awareness about this remarkable achievement in infrastructure development.